Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the edX product marketing team, and today I'm going to be going over how to use moldability validation to confirm that your mold designs fit production criteria. I'm beginning with a coffee machine. The part we are going to be investigating is the tray that sits beneath the coffee cups. I've already loaded this into a new window. The first thing I'm going to do to begin is click over to the molded part design tab. Moldability validation functions very similarly to other validation options found in edX. To begin, we are going to set our preferences by selecting Molded Part Design Preferences. When this opens, there are three tabs labeled General, Moldability Validation, and Feature Validation. For our purposes, Moldability Validation is all we are concerned with. As you may notice, there are a list of seven different parameters we can choose to test for. To begin, I'm going to leave the vertical walls off, but we will test for each of the other six parameters. You may notice that each parameter has options for input limit values, and additionally, each parameter will be highlighted with their own individual color if errors arise. Once we are comfortable with the parameters and values selected, we can begin to run our validation checks. To do this, I'm going to now select Moldability Validation. When this is done, each parameter populates into the Molded Part Design Navigator, and associated results can now be found. In these tests, all of our checks were successful, which is why none of the part was highlighted with the colors associated to each parameter. With these tests performed, one last thing I want to look at is what would happen if we implement the vertical walls parameter into our tests by going back into preferences. When creating this tray, a large number of vertical walls were produced. To see what this does for our validation checks, I'm going to rerun the validation test. Once the tests have run, you can see there is an error message along each vertical wall. Additionally, you can also see that each wall has been highlighted blue to demonstrate that the errors were from the vertical walls. Draft angles are an important part of mold designs, as they are needed in part ejection. Failure to do so can lead to drag or scrape lines. Seeing these errors, we now know that to produce this tray, we should either change our design and add a draft angle to these walls, or look into options outside of mold production. In conclusion, in this video, we went over how to use moldability validation tests. To start, we set our parameters and values and preferences. After that, we ran our tests and evaluated results. And finally, we finished by exploring what warnings and errors look like and what they can mean for your product's production. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.